You're watching Living Black, coming to you from the Blue Mountains. Consultation by the Queensland Government is underway as the state looks to review alcohol management plans. Letitia Griffin reports.
Peaceful and pristine, a tropical paradise beside the ocean. About a 40-minute drive east of Cairns lies the small Aboriginal community of Yarrabah. But just before you enter the town, there are clear warning signs on the strict conditions of alcohol use for the area. The alcohol management plans, also known as the AMP, have been in place here for 8 years, but critics say they want them scrapped.
We really haven't seen much change at all. There's still domestic violence. Kids are still not attending school on a regular basis. The alcohol it still finds its place here. People still find a way to bring it over, so this really hasn't done much.
The issue has evolved from a debate around alcohol and its social impact to one about civil rights and nationhood.
They want the same laws as everyone else, and the alcohol laws, if you're white fella, you can buy grog, and if you're black fella, you can't. Now, how can we hold our head upright as Australians when you have separate laws? You can't.
The review of the AMP fulfills an election promise made by the current state government.
Part of it was that I would send representatives from my department into the communities for as long, basically, as they needed. And so far, three of those communities have taken up that offer. And we're negotiating now directly with the councils and other community groups.
But the review doesn't guarantee that the bans will be lifted. Communities that want restrictions removed must suggest other ways to address the violence and disruption alcohol can bring. On Queensland's other coast, in the Gulf of Carpentaria, lies the small community of Mornington Island. Locals here have come up with some ideas on what could work better than the current bans.
Me personally, I would like to see a lift and put a carriage restriction in place. A permit where we can, you know, where we can enjoy it. A permit so we can enjoy it at home, you know. Say for an example, state origin nights, you know, like, and grand final nights, we can't even have a drink. You know?
The thing I don't like is alcohol in the community. I don't mind the canteen or the tavern being open as drink here, no takeaways. It could save a lot of problems in the community, the underage drinking.
But back in Yarrabah, many say they'd welcome any change.
You know, there's a stigma attached to Indigenous communities in that we're all the same. We're not all the same. We may have the same issues, but how we deal with them is different.
The grog bans apply to 19 Indigenous communities around Queensland. They were introduced to tackle alcohol-related violence. Police regularly check cars coming in and out of the community, making sure they only have the prescribed amount of alcohol. But since the introduction of the AMP, those in Yarrabah say criminal convictions have increased and sly grogging is now a new problem. Lucy Rogers from the Yarrabah Aboriginal Corporation for Women says it hasn't made any difference in her line of work.
It hasn't played its true role, I guess, in making it better, being reviewed every, you know, year and say, you know, what's happening here, what's happening there.
But not every community has the same view. While some want the laws gone, others say it's working. In Aurukun, North Queensland, it's been reported that school attendance has risen and domestic violence has dropped significantly. For some, getting rid of these bans will destroy any progress that's been made.
If you look at the history, you look at the statistics, these things will be in dire straits again. You had crime reducing down from 22 in every 1,000 down to 7. We want that continue. We're having kids start getting into school, they're starting to get educated. We don't want these things to start reverting back again.
Back in Yarrabah, locals are now waiting for their turn to have a say.
I would love to see more things on the ground for the kids here. I would love to see more the corporate sector at least give it a go in investing in our community in terms of their social involvement in helping to deal with some of these issues.
Consultations are continuing across these communities with no set deadlines for their submissions to the state government.
And if you'd like to see that story again, just go to our website.